So I guess I'm back. Cleaned up the stuff. So I guess I can just go log in and do my thing again. Allows me to log in. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to actually do a little bit different this time. Damn it. A lot of noise in the apartment. Because of the wind, we're gonna have stormy weather. Yesterday was hot, and today there's some cold weather blowing in. So let's just touch a file, or yeah, let's just see if we can actually echo something in a file, if we're allowed. Oh yeah, but this is permissive mode anyway, so blah, text. Okay, close this. If we have any FC denials, yeah, of course we do. Basically, we're going to back up a single file this time. And then, because I think we're getting to the point where we might be able to actually restore. So, yeah, I created that file. Let's go to our backup solution. Show my settings, and then just change it. So folders to backup. Christ. Let's just. It can only backup folders, seems. Is that right? Can I only backup folders? Yeah, I can only backup folders. So actually that also already showed me a lot of stuff that I need to do, so it's probably going to need to use recently used stuff and DTK stuff. Yeah, so here we have a lot of stuff. Config. Here we have config. This is DTK. Let's have a look. This is DTK. Yeah, GTK. So we need to take care of that. But that's just so much work. It's incredible. Oh, it's this thing. They are the prefs. And then. File roller also does that. GTK dance. Recently used also. Recently used. so much functionality. But on the other hand, you have to keep in mind that I'm not just confining one app, I'm now doing three apps at one time or something like that. If not more. So let's just restore combat stuff. Okay, let's go back and have a look at some other stuff. It's reading bash home. Well, let's just copy this over. Eyes out. Let's just copy it over first. So bash, that's fine. Bin, we did we allow that already? Bin. No, we didn't. Did we? Oh yeah, we did. So we can remove this. Cache home. Let's just allow that to search cache home. Config, recreate, oh, we took care of that. Data home, it's reading data home. There's, for now, I'm just going to ignore that. It's getting attribute of GPD secret, let's ignore that. This should be allowed by now. This can be probably removed. Yeah, it's just listing stuff. So that's can be silently denied. Use a home dirty listing. Yeah, that's actually something that we need to take care of. But it's actually use a home dirty home booty. Actually no. Use a home DT and use a home. I need to actually do that right. This can be removed. This should be go up. Not sure what that is all about. Yeah, it's trying to basically list everything. And this can be removed. And then we basically need to allow it to... Not sure what this is all about. Oh, that's one too. Yeah, that's fine. Need to allow it. This stuff. And then basically this whole stuff. But not, and then this, I'm going to comment it out, but first I'm going to change the name to protect the innocents. This basically have to do with that file dialog, where you basically want some decent representation. actually this. This, I'm going to just do this one here, like that. See, that shouldn't be any, this should be actually like this, right? But yeah, that seems fine. Let's just change the name only. You see, it needs to be able to give a decent representation of your user home there when you open that file selection thingy. Now let's go back and deal with that dir. So basically you can only backup dirs, ain't that something? Ls make dir blah, and then mv blah text blah ls blah. Okay, now see if we clean 5 6. Let's don't audit it so that can be ignored. Now just basically false to ignore, yeah, basically everything. But we can remove, yeah, actually we can let's keep that in though. Let's just first add my login user, this the backup blah, but don't backup this one. Then go to storage. Okay, now let's have a look. They adopted a bunch of stuff. It seems that the type transition doesn't actually work. Well, not quite that. What actually is that this file here is actually created straight up in the temp directory. Let's have a look at the temp-t. You see, it's actually creating that file straight up. And what's there, it's reading temp itself. So yeah. Nasty. There you go. So let's go to the temp stuff. So Tempty, it's actually reading that there, so then also opening it. Read open. That's a generic temp there. And then with regard to the file, we actually have a write, create, unlink, open, execute, but that makes sense. So basically all we need is a additional transition for file. And that should take care of that. Then we have a bunch of DVFS stuff here. SFTP. And now that file, actually the TPG. TPG doesn't seem to be actually needing to search temp. What is it? Oh yeah, that's fine here. That's fine. That's fine. Alright, so now DVFS. DVFSD, and then it's, what is it? SFTP. Now we have a bunch of stuff here. And I was wondering, when would that pop up? Was still pretty clear, clean here. So we have a stream connecting. This can be removed. This should be there. This should be there. This dev stuff. Use home dirty. So it's actually home root t. Use home dirty search, but it's searching. Get attribute. It's searching data empty for something, but not quite sure what that is. Oh yeah, it's, yeah. So these two, I'll add those. U, and then I'll just add data empty in there. Data empty. Vconf t. And get attribute search. See, it's trying to get to something in data. It's looking for something in data and the local share. And that's why it needs to traverse. Now, there's something weird going on. This dev PTS thing. What is that? Grab dev PTS. Because that should be user PTS 4. There is no PTS 4. PTS 1. PTS 0. Now that's PTI 2, 3, there is no 4, so I don't know what the funk is going on there. Okay, might want to make a note of that stuff. Hotplug is doing some stuff right about now. I might want to make a note about that. DVFSD SFTPD SFTP. Check this. Hop lug. Oh, and I need to probably require the type, but see about that later. So hot plug is actually connecting, and that's, yeah, that makes sense now. And it's doing this shit and that shit. I guess as if, yeah, it doesn't actually create it. So what the heck is creating that PTS? PTS4. Is it still there? My login user. Weird. That's weird. No, I don't know what the hell is going on, what that is. I don't know what created it. Nothing creates it. Same here, generic dev PTS. Okay, I don't know. Look at the chat. Where was I? Because that's it. Make sure, let's just. Yeah, that dev PTS bothers me. Let's have a look at. See if I overlooked some dubious chatting. Let's assume that way. Dubious chat seems gravy. I don't think it's chatting to anything on the system bus. So that should be clean probably, yeah. Okay, let's just know the time. 12:10. And let's just restore this. See what this date brings us. Nothing. That doesn't make sense at all. Of course, that's true. That does indeed make no sense. Some stuff. Data home T. Set attribute of home root T. Are you kidding me? Let's have a close look at that. They adopt stuff. Execute. IO nice. That can be ignored. Execute node trans TART, that's generic to me. Then execute Python can be ignored. Execute duplicity can be ignored. Execute duplicity executes best can be ignored. Execute duplicity can be ignored. Execute bash. Uname can be ignored. Shell execute uname can be ignored. Bash can be ignored. Now here's set attribute cache home T. Right. User home T. Set attribute user home T. Yeah, that's fine. But it doesn't actually restore the context, but oh yeah, right. Now I know. So actually, oh actually I don't know, but you know, it actually tries to set attribute on slash home. Are you kidding me? Actually tries to set attribute on root itself, on the root there itself. Are you kidding me? Recently used, so that's something. They end up needs to do. So that's actually why it's messing with the data recently used. Okay, so that's something. Do we know something? They the. And we can actually use that for press. also needs to get there. It also, well, it's actually allowed that access anyway, so that's just fine. But it's actually trying to do all kinds of nasty things. Guessing what these should actually do. Set attributes of everything as far as I'm concerned. And write file. So attribute of everything and write file. Let's just make this. Default file. Write is not defined for block file. Weird that the attribute is not defined for a FIFO file. Set attribute is not for class block file. Now, wait, sorry, now I know. Course. No, this is going to take a little while. Oh no. Actually, first list blah. Blah is gone. Let's see if we can back it up now. I'll restore now. So this program is not as Linux aware. A mess. See, this is just crazy. Shut down. First things first, SSH TCP socket shut down. How in the hell am I gonna deal with this stuff? So this program is just not as Linux aware. Gets attributes type of fast, I can do that. Give me a break, please. So, don't audit. Don't audit that. Crying out loud. We need to just look, we can't actually take care of everything. So what I'm going to do is just so that's basically all I can do. I can make it very complex, but that's just not a good idea. This program should just use ZFS createcom on restore, but complex stuff. Tough decisions to make in life. Tough decisions to make, and a lot of testing. We're at 12:29. Best we can do. That's the best we can do. Now with regard to damp. Set attribute on a file. Now with regard to the transition. And with regard to this stuff here. There. Right create add now. Same for this stuff. This is really some very limited functionality. Sucks. Let's try something else. Let's back up. Now let's remove that. Oh, and I can't actually access that. Fuck. And it's, yeah, doing it with the generic stuff. At least it seems to work. This is yeah, that was fine. That should be ignored. Okay, so that's quite complex. So what do we have? We have some stuff that we want to do. So it wants to get attribute. This is done. Okay, let me think about this. Let's just go ahead and make this work first because, yeah, it's just a mess. So let's just edit the file a little bit. And this should be allowed for now. This should be allowed for now. Might want to require this stuff here. Oh yeah, we actually wanted to see if it works without it. same goes for this stuff, so I might as well just. Hotman Humpty. ETC runtime T. That's it. So we logged off. Kill. We find it from that. Oh, and actually before kill, there is other stuff that we take out and need to go. So at this point, we're going to try this in enforcing mode. Now there's just a lot of stuff that basically. Oh yeah, and we need to also. I forgot that. Let's fire log. See if we overlooked some. Actually, I have overlooked some data dub UDisk data dub. Somehow it's crapping. Crying out loud. Oh yeah. That's why. Might as well just do it manually. really messy this. But yeah, I gotta do it, that's the way I am. Basically, after a backup, you'll really need to restore comms. Which means that you'll need to be able to restore comms. Which basically means you can declassify your stuff. Basically means messed up. Messed up situation. Okay, LSLZ, oh, my login user. RMRF blah. I'll search MAVCTS 1248 audit to allow. Get enforce, set enforce one. Now just yeah, try do it. Let's just assume the simplest first. So yeah, you're logging in, you're basically creating a dir, make dir test, cd test, nano, or yeah, actually echo test. Okay, lsalz, it's there with a proper type. So yeah, you created that. Now you're logging out of your crapping out. Then basically you're trying to create a backup. I want to set make my settings. Now I don't want to back this one up here, so I can remove this one. But I want to back up something else. So my login user, you want to back up test, open test, and then storage is actually SSH net KB. Info port 22, Dominic, and username. Okay, set that up. Overview, backup now. Enable to spawn the SSH program. Let's have a look. Let's start because, well, obviously, there's just a lot of stuff going on. Now this can be ignored, this can be ignored. You have here one important thingy, or important. The dip is dead, ain't it? Yep. Add that somewhere. Let's see what else we have before we build. We have SFTP trying to search dev PTS. DVFS DSFTP, and it was messing with dev PTS, wasn't it? Yeah, dev PTS. So let's get attribute. Right. Let's have a look. What else do we have? This can be ignored. This can be ignored. That's basically it. So less for log messages. Seems okay. So this supposedly should get us at least somewhere. Let's see what we have. This is a thing that we need to take, get rid of, but we can do that. I thought I already did that. The dub. Fucking mess. Only user content. So yeah, this is this. It's kind of fucked up to do that right now. So I'll just put this in there. It's actually not that big. It's only a single file, so why would I make a big fuss out of that? But why the hell it wants to get attribute of that LXC file there? Well, I'll add it where the other weird stuff is. Okay, let's try and back this up, or put this back, restore this. Successfully. Don't audit it. This is allowed. This is don't audit it. User home dirt tset attribute is don't audit it. This is allowed. This is all not applicable. Okay, let's just remove that dir ls all or ls home my login user, and then test rmrf. Let's see if that now still restores. Seems so. Yeah, this it all looks good. The tester was it. It's restored properly. Let's try and schedule this daily, forever. Let's see what we have, what we got, yeah. That's probably cron involved, isn't it? Doesn't seem to be. It's kind of hard to less for log messages. No debug problems. Oh yeah, we have one. We have SFTP chatting to prefs. So prefs SFTP. The prefs. Let's set into SFTP. This is just only one scenario, can you believe that? So you can do all kinds of backups, but this is just really one thing. Now, let's just do it another way. Let's just open this here. And here you have the test. And here you can revert to previous version. Now that's not gonna work. Currently. But at least it should show me something. See? It's trying to execute data. So we basically need to make a transition here. From Nautilus to Deodup. So Deodup gets run by this, but also by my login user Naut. Huge project is. But, it's okay. Try that again. I can't actually open a file yet. I don't have a text editor done. Let's just try this again. Refer to previous version. Forward. It's working. So yeah, in a sense it's working, but there's still a lot of messy stuff there. Still messy. There's probably some chatting going on here. I would imagine. Doesn't seem to be. Doesn't seem to be any chatting. So yeah. Poo poo. What a mess. See, it actually mounts. It actually mounts. But something went wrong. Let's see what that is. Why would that go wrong? That's why. Nautilus wants to set to DVFS. So two GFS. Yeah. You know what? I'll use this. Quite messy indeed. Quite complex. How all these components interact and operate, it's mind-boggling. And considering all that stuff, it's actually pretty decent. See, now I can actually also use this stuff. Question is whether you would want to want to allow that, but that's not my call to make. I'm just confining stuff. So you have some this string connecting. And then we have a certain cache. I'll just add it somewhere here. And then we have GVFS. DVFSD, SFTP, actually certain cache. So that's basically this cache. Can I actually unmount this crap? Probably not. Oh, ain't that about something? Alright, so what I'm going to do now is just forget all about this and just act as if I'm stupid. I'm going to change something though. To use this stuff here. And then, because I made that note, I should go. Make that note here below. Though it's probably a bad time to do that now. Kind of mind-boggling. Kinda. As you might well be. We're going to do as if we don't know. And then just remove test. But this time we're not going to remove the known host file. Clear. Assert 1315. Okay, so we're clean. We're in enforcing mode. We silently deny stuff. So let's just act like we don't know. Act like we don't know anything. That's just the file browser. I'm gonna create a folder. Hello. And inside that folder, I can't create a file. I'll just open the terminal then. And inside that hello folder, I create a file. So cd hello, and let's just say sec 100 hello text. So we have our first ABC denial already, but that's something I know already what it is. LS L human readable, and that seems like god hello text. Does that work? Yeah, it does work. Alright, so we have that stuff. Then basically what we want to make a backup. That's what we do, we backup stuff. So we're not going to backup this folder here, but instead we're going to backup this folder here. Okay, and then basically we're going to use SSH for storage. And that's basically server is SSH net KB info port 22, and the login of the user is Dominic, and then that's basically it. I'm going to create a backup. Now I need to add a key, unlock my key. And that works. And then create a password for this file. Remember that password though. And now we need to unlock the GPG key. And it's creating. So that's done. Let's have a look at our keys. Let's see if it actually added some keys in here. And it actually did add some keys. So backup encryption password, unlock password for my this one, and this is basically what we created. So yeah, that's so far so good. So now let's just go into this stuff here and just delete it. Well, actually, let's just refer it to a previous version first. Forward. Forward. Restore. It's preparing, it's doing its job. Close, successfully restored. Now let's just delete this file. Empty trash. Let's go back to our application here and just say restore this. Close this one here and now go back to my home directory, and there's my hello and hello text again. So yeah, that seems to work. The default seem, the basic seems to work. Let's see what for AVC denials we're getting. Not much, so that's pretty cool. Let's just add that in there. So that's just pretty damn impressive, if I may say so myself. And actually, this this one. Where did I add it? It's actually something that needs to be much broader. Because now we only hit one issue, but be aware of this. Exclamation mark file type, and then file in there, because basically this basically will silently hide legit stuff as well. But yeah, I'm pretty impressed by this work myself. Because yeah, I spent 3 weeks doing this stuff, so this actually also works. Back up. Let's just also open the system monitor. There are some things that I'm still wondering about though. If you look at this stuff, It's all just going fine. DFUSD, SFTP. Where's my backup program? Or did I close that already? No, I didn't. This data dipmon. Now, I haven't actually tested this periodic update stuff. Periodic backup stuff. I haven't actually tested that. So yeah, that might actually. Issue. Nope, we don't. It's just clean. It's just clean. Let's just log out and log in without actually, oh, that doesn't work. Without actually clearing anything. Oh, and this is the wrong. Cancel this one. We have an SE Linux alert. Dismiss that. So yeah, there's some stuff that we need to take care of. Let's just do that. So this is DTK related. DTK home T. So I'm going to ABRT Apple. And just add that in. Do we have any config stuff? Yeah, we do. Source good attributes right now, good. So we can remove that here. ABRT Apple. And Evo Alarm, same stuff. Evo Alarm. easy session. And G set D. G set D. Might actually, after this, need more D shell. We have Nautilus search provider actually wants to read also, but the read is not applicable, I think. But I think sooner or later they probably also all want to do this. And network manager and Apple, I think they all want to actually read that GTK stuff for some reason. But we'll see. And then we need to take care of these datadub cache. It's, yeah, it's currently only search, but it wants more. So there's datadub mom. Isn't actually allowed to search cache in the first place. Oh yeah, it is. Now we know why it wants to do that. And then we have SFTP doing some signaling. GVFS, D, SFTP, signal to self, do we have any selves? Not yet. Now, that's loud. Let's make... as a module. It's also... have a look at dbus, see if we're overlooking any dbus less far log messages, and we have a lot of the house. But no Divas seems. No Divas. So yeah, let's just log out. So yeah, this just needs a lot of testing, obviously. There's a lot of cleaning up to do. So now probably it's stuff related. Probably opening the TTK file. Here we have, well actually it doesn't actually do that, although now the service provider does read that there actually. But here we have it reading the cache data mon. The mon actually listing that. So that's actually read and open. And that's once more. Data mon. This is done. But here we have that service provider who actually wants to read that dir. It actually wants to read that there. Read open. So yeah, obviously a lot of stuff to take care of. But we're getting somewhere. Log out. And we are at 13:35. And we're clean at 13:35. Let's log in. No ABC in the house. That'll be the day. No ABC in the house. Wow. Funky. So yeah, welcome to your confined thingy. Nice. Let's just remove that to trash. And let's just open this app. Back up now. Restore now. But that's just generic content, so that's just the simple stuff. And there it is again. So yeah, that's that stuff. This still works. Oh, here we have actually this one work. that remote disk analyze stuff. That's not going to work. But no, enough. But there's DBIS something, yeah, probably. Yeah, there's DBIS stuff going on here. So Baobab wants to do some DBISing. So let's just tail and 50 either to allow. And just add this one in for Baobab. LS RM test text. Yes, nano Baobab. Baobab. And Baobab wants to DBIS chat to SFTP. So let's allow that. But yeah, you can decide not to want that, you don't want this. But for me, who am I to decide what's right or what's wrong? So it's stuck for a while. Let's try that again, see if this made any difference. Not quite. ABC denial. Dismiss that though. It's stream connecting as well. It's stream connecting. See if that makes any difference. But yeah, functionality is getting more and more complete. The desktop is becoming more and more useful. Now at least we get some stuff here. Might have been denying some stuff, silently denying some stuff, obviously. So yeah, something might just be something might be silently blocked. Okay, well at least I fixed the obvious stuff. This, at least this works. No, this doesn't work. You know that. Or it works maybe, but only partly. Actually doesn't work. Oh yeah, it does work. Took a little while. Cannot scan folder. Help works. Let's just print that. I'm just testing out some stuff. Print preview works. Print again. Print this. I'll print that to documents. Print. So that's probably printed. Let's go to my documents. There I have it. Thumbnail is creating properly. Let's open it with Document Viewer. It works. Let's save this file. Save a copy. Save this in. Let's see. Recently used actually does something. Let's save this file here in my home directory. File could not be saved. Oh yeah, that this is a false positive. It is saved. It is saved. Let's have a look. Let's go to my home directory. Home. And here it is. See, so it is actually saved. Just says that it doesn't save it, but it saves it. See if I can open it. See, it's there. Open this file in the containing folder. That works as well. So yeah, a lot of stuff works. Also, a lot of stuff still doesn't work. For example, there I might be able to create a link. It's not even. Oh yeah, here make link, but that's not going to work. See, cannot create a link. Making symbolic link is denied, and then you get an thing. I'm gonna look at it. See link create. So I just basically need to. I need to add that, but not now. But just to show you that there are rough edges indeed. But overall, think about this. It's just actually just working. PS out C grab 1012. So yeah, we have SSH here. SSB, FTP. Metadata, all these processes. Now let's look at home, LSRZ, home, my login user. So yeah, it's all confined, config, cache, bash, pools, gpg, gtk bookmarks, hello is generic, that should be in generic, ice out, gconf, my output PDF, it's generic, SSH is confined. So yeah, it looks fine and dandy to me. So yeah, that's basically it for today. Let's see if some other stuff. So basically, next project would be to do the Nautilus Sentoo. And then after that, we might actually be able to do something more or even more interesting, like for example Mozilla Browser, which is of course one of the things that we'd like to protect. And I have some nice ideas there as well. And of course, you want your IRC client to be protected and restricted, and of course, you need a text editor to edit files, so we need to do that as well. And maybe your cam stuff. Oh yeah, you want your instant messaging stuff. Want done as well. So yeah, look here, let's just create a archive here from that hello file for just for shits and giggles. So new and blah, call it blah. Create it and then add it, some stuff in there, hello, add it, and now there's also a thing, here it is, let's just extract it from the browser. So this doesn't work yet, Sentoo, see, doesn't, and maybe there's an, yeah, there comes the AVC now, so that don't work yet, but this extract here should work, and that is. And it does blah too. Move to trash works, rename works. Browser network. Yeah. ABC Denials. So, a lot of ABC Denials. Let's have a look. We have file roller reparents. So, let's just take out that. So yeah, a lot of loose ends. It's always going to be a lot of loose ends. So let's paste this in here and let's see where that belongs. User home teeter reparents. So reparents, copy, paste, reparent, and we'll move this here. What else do we have? We have DVFS searching thumb home key. Copy. DVFSD. SFTP. And then thumb home key. Where is the thumb home key actually? Oh, it's actually. Yeah, it's probably cache somewhere. So let's make that get attribute in search. So these are the easy ones. Once you have the basics out of the way, the basically the fundamentals, then these are just pretty obvious. So here you're basically Nautilus sent to, and you have a this is can be ignored. This is actually that link file where we created that wanted to create that symlink. But I'm not going to support that right now. And this is as he applet actually executing as he troubleshoot. But this one Nautilus sent to is for another day, which is basically the sent to functionality. Make, and then I'm going to really just end this episode. It's nice. But you need a break every once in a while. You need a break every once in a while. That's just mandatory. So yeah, the desktop is becoming more and more useful. Don't you think? Let's see if I can. Doesn't actually do that. That's shitty. See, there's, oh, now we're having some new ABC denials. It doesn't actually, the search provider isn't actually able to find some files. Yeah, the search provider. Gbox search provider. So yeah, that's bugged, so let's try that. Also, I need to quit. Gbox search P. But yeah, this is one that's really not. So what you get is, it's actually searching. Get attribute to search. And this is actually reading the password file, that's no problem. Get attributes, open, read. What else do we have? We have the doc search provider. This is the box. Firewall reparent. Here, this one. It's actually listing user home dirty. So let's just Nautilus search provider. Nautilus search P. User home dirty. Reopen. lot of loose ends, I'm afraid. Blah. And now it's actually returning my blah. TTC. Config, searches and config. Here we have some search provider stuff. That's a lot. What's going on here? This actually needs to do a bunch of stuff. Actually needs to write. This is some stuff. Damn, I'm opening up a can of worms. Let's just see that D-box, grab D-box. Gnome boxes. LSLZ. Home. My. Login. User. Config. Found boxes. Yep, there we have it. Let's see. Config. Found boxes. Box config home T nano T box service provider, and let's just type T box config home T. There's just a lot of stuff. That attribute file type user home type and then basically add the type transition already. Type transition and then it's config home T the Gbox non boxes. What? Gnome boxes, yeah. Nobody else is gonna do. So we have an ad name. Search get attribute. Now we have a dbox. That looks okay. Yep. Then let's have a look at some other stuff out there. This stuff here. Let's allow this check mining stuff. And metadata. Actually, just paste this all in. Now it's search provider. Let's paste this in here. This above. So yeah, we have some get attributes that we probably need to get attributes of user home type. Home to it serves in cache, so that can be allowed. This is done. Eyes out doesn't necessarily need access to that. This one get attribute search. This doesn't necessarily need access to it. Here we have it accessing that random. And just need shouldn't go so fast though. Check minor config. This can be removed. It shouldn't go so fast. Who's on the T right? No. This is a don't audit. And then I allow audit access. the week might be. It doesn't actually open. Then use empty get attribute and search. Attributes of everything. And it's already taken care of. Is on to do a certain attribute. Hard to tell. Search open. Not sure this, but okay. Okay, but this I'll have one more look at the stuff, and then I'm really gonna end it now, because, well, this is a never-ending story, obviously. Never gonna be perfect. But this is it. Alright, log off, clean up. Hello? Tell? Something went wrong. So, yeah. Shell needs to chat to itself. Opening up a can of worms again. Search provider needs to Gbox search provider needs to chat to GVFSD. Can't even. Oh yeah, I did. give us this, and we have Nautilus Search Provider actually sending message to Tracker Store. Ain't that something? Can't open it up. Oh yeah, I can. The escape key somehow didn't. Brightness and look, how the hell did that happen? Okay, that's it. Clean up this stuff. And that's it for today. I've had enough. It's really been an adventure. I need some lunch. I haven't had any lunch yet. And then I need another cup of coffee, you know. First things first, though. Just cleaning up the SSH stuff as well. And then Nano, Home, Dominic, SSH, out. And then clear this one, this test one. And then LSLZ temp, RMRS temp. And get enforced. Yeah, so we're done for today.